bench had 37 points. Five different players had threes in that big win against the Pacers and Steve Nash.
You step back, all the weight transfers to your heels, and not a good way to shoot the ball.
And he's playing big minutes. There's a block by Earl Clark, and Nash, who will really control the ball now with Kobe out of the game. As he probes down to the baseline, gives it to Clark, rides it up and in. Steve Nash making it happen. And tonight with a win.
Two quick fouls on Thompson. He's headed to the sideline and makes a dead ball.
Yeah, he's a relentless rebounder. Speaking of rebounding, Dwight Howard with his back leaning way back, tipped that one in.
Yeah, front. Dwight, as we get another look at the cap on his attempt there, you can see he's just about under the basket, just reaches back and taps it. And fortunately, it goes in. That's a great effort.
Madison has learned how to shoot that with consistency. Meta trying to go hard to the hole. Kicks it out to Earl Clark. He runs into some defensive trouble. Meeks attacks. Oh, Joni slams it home.
Talked about bailing a guy out. Nice cut by Jody. And with quickness, he gets to the rim before the defense can get in a help situation. Just goes up and throws one down. Nice block, Wood. Very aggressive on the offensive end.
Earl Clark with the basketball. He's going to stop and pop from about 17 and knock it down.
Dwight Howard.
He shot that one so fast as if he thought the shot clock was winding down. He had plenty of time.
Spin by MWP, and he muscles it up with his left hand.
Yeah.
About 6 or 7 years back. Nash playing defense. Two on the shot clock. One, they're going to have to put it up. As they beat the clock, Salmons doesn't get there. Chuck Hayes was boxed out. Look at Dwight. Going to the dribble.
And that was good individual defense to force what I would think would be a 24-second violation.
Jamison knocks it down.
The injured Kobe Bryant, Jody Meeks, making the most of the situation so far with his first deuce. And Antoine Jamison, throughout his career, a score. He was 16 out of Carl's camp. Shows a good team defense to start on that last possession by the Kings as the Lakers were swarming, and then individually Steve Nash one-on-one with Salmons. And Salmons is a real good one-on-one player. That's pretty good defense by Steve Nash.
The other Steve is in the game, Steve Blake. He's going to fire it up as he gets it, and he just
without Cousins on the floor.
Patterson was really working the pick and pop against the Bulls. Boy, Nash just gave it right to Earl Peace, who was just standing right next to him. Since that All-Star break, Lakers are 10-3. Playing great basketball. Jamison open. World Peace finished with the left hand. Jump shot, Marcus Thornton, taken by Blake. Thornton averages about 13 points a game, stands 6'4". Here's a shot outside, knock it down. Lakers continue.
Another from long distance. He's 2 out of 3 now from behind the arc as Steve Blake gets the assist. And Jamison gets the hoop. Intentional act, so no whistle, no kicking the ball.
Now, last 6 games, Steve Blake, how about this? 34 assists, 5 turnovers. Progress. Shot clock is at 11, game clock at 15. Jamison, he'll drive, go all the way, scoop it up and in.
Scoring 33 points on 59% from the field, while the Kings with 27. On an offensive-minded first 12 minutes. And speaking of offensive-minded, Antoine Jamison only played 7 minutes, but he's the Lakers' leading scorer with 8. He's got 8 points in 7 minutes, so he's the guy that comes in and gives them that lift on the offensive end. And trust me, without number 20.
And an offensive goaltend, they did not blow the whistle.
I thought it was good, no call.
Earl Clark, 15-footer. Bang, knock it down. Points in the paint. 14 for each team. Steve Blake probes baseline. Oh, wide open is Dwight. Boy, that worked beautifully.
Steve Blake, their little hand check, but the probe by Steve Blake, the bigs, both of them, Hayes and Aldridge, looking at each other like, I thought you were. You know what happens when you think? Y'all weaken the team.
Dwight
and Blake already. That's pretty good production.
And Cole Aldridge checking in. He was the third member of that trade. Antoine outside. He's hot.
They may go over and look at it, but they're calling no, just a hold. But Jamison scoring, knocks down yet another one from behind the from perimeter at least. And
Thornton bounces it for Jason Thompson, backing in, little isolation one-on-one. Boy, Dwight comes over to knock it away on the defensive help.
You see, that's the kind of play where, you know, I know it's easier said looking at it from this vantage point, but our Carl's camp shows Dwight's got such a clear path at it. Just catch it. Don't spike it. Just grab it. Keep control of it. All it does is...
And all of a sudden, it's just a two-point game at 43-41, a 10-2 run. Dwight Howard goes up to get it and throws it down.
Wasn't the greatest pass. It was there, and all you have to do is get it into vicinity, and Dwight can reach back and make it happen.
Yeah, plays like that showing that Dwight is a lot healthier than he was earlier in the year. Remember the back surgery last April. Lob under again. Finish strong. Dwight Howard on the alley-oop. Crowd loves it.
Well, the pass went into Meta on the low post. And a nice dive. And Meta world peace with almost a touch pass. It gives it to Dwight. So back-to-back possessions. It's Dwight Howard. First Steve Nash. Throw it up. Throw it down. And then coming down a little slower. Meta world peace. Gets the assist. Nice.
Shade Robert, and he's really getting the job done tonight.
Yeah, you're amazed. The guy is feeling good. You can tell that his back is feeling really good. But the thing I'm more impressed with, that he's 4-for-4 from the free throw line, so we want to keep that going.
And then you've got Jamison with 11 and Steve Blake running the offense, 6 assists. He's
so worried about getting his shot blocked. He's only 2 feet from the rim.
Dominating at this, at the other end of the floor. Both. Oh, Meta once again.
He's taking you as many dribbles as necessary to get where he wants to go.
Posting up with Salmons, and Meta comes over to the clock.
Well, the offensive end, it was Meta world peace. Dribble, 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 and then just throw it up and get the roll. Then on the defensive end, he comes over with that left hand and swats it out of the hand of John Salmons. Dwight's on the floor. You just have to play him to drive. You have to make sure you take his, as best you can, take his jump shot away.
Earl Clark, touch and shoot. Like to give it up often.
You're going to give it up now.
He does, and Blake barely saves it. Then goes baseline, throws it up, not there. Wild scramble. Blake gets it, and then Clark is fouled.
Tries a hesitation shot while in the air. Gets that rejected. Falls to the floor. The ball comes right back to him, and he looks like he wants to get an assist as Earl Clark gets fouled in the
game.
14 points in 14 minutes, so that's how he's shooting.
Steve Nash, that rolls around and settles it. Let it get away here in the second quarter. Nash goes around 1-2, floating in the lane. He knocks it down. We're tied again at 50. You know, one more time, we'll take a look at it.
Nash's basket goes in, and they inbound the ball. The clock stopped. It doesn't start again until the ball is touched. And right there, it touched the body of Tyreke Evans. So the clock.
Chris James, Rob, Access Sportsnet Studio. It is time for the Jack in the Box halftime report. Fellas.
You can put up 56. You're getting it done. Dwight, a big part of that offense as he's just still looking to get himself where he wants to be. But obviously with the results he's had of late, you can see how he trusts his back. And when he's trusting his back, that means it's feeling a lot better. And then off the bench, Antoine Jamison really gave him a good spark, especially in the early part or later part of that first quarter when he put in 8 points.
Had 8 lead changes and 6 ties in this game. I think he's led by as many as 10 in that first half. World peace hits a 3 from the outside.
Defensive support, maybe not have to take that foul.
Jason Thompson, 0-for-6 tonight for the Kings. World peace, 2 in a row. Got it!
About this month.
Come on.
His last one, though, you talked about being a line drive. Not much margin for error, but when you shoot it that straight, 18 points, only 3 rebounds, but he's been a major factor.
Filling in for DeMarcus Cousins as Steve Nash, little step back. It's Dwight Howard. Steve Blake takes it away. Lakers will get an opportunity. They've got some numbers. Antoine's alone. That's a long 2.
Should have been reset to 14.
Outside official called the over and back. That's why we called it initially. Here's Blake from the outside. He hits the 3. Been in leader of the second unit. Lakers lead by 3, Stu. As this ball's to Salmons. Doubled up. There's Blake harassing. 5 on the shot clock.
They got it to the right man.
Yeah, didn't they, though? Patterson. Salmons is not the offensive force you want.
Once Patterson got it in the paint.
Steve Blake, fall away, baseline, of course.
But he didn't handle it properly,
and the defender was coming to make the block. And so he says, let me step out. Knock down the baby jumper.
Long arms, gives it to Steve Nash. Lakers shooting 53.8%. Oh, world peace had wonderful position.
Ignition and the one dribble over to improve that angle.
Blake running the floor, transition, world peace, reverse slam is good.
We're here, might force yet another timeout by Keith Smart.
Lakers trying to get four games above 500 for the first time this year. Jamison all the way and scores, a play we've seen often. Gets it from Nash.
Well, again, you know, we talk about how Jamison is the master of that slip screen. Maybe we should change it to just Jamison obviously is a very good basketball player, but more importantly, Jamison is a very smart player. I mean, this guy just knows how to read the defense. And you were talking about how Steve Nash and Steve Blake are really finding the right people.
Mm-hmm.
Nash has 12 assists. Blake with 7, 19 of the 24, their point guard. Well, I guess that's the way it should be since that's they have the ball in their hand.
Here's another look.
Yeah, our Carl's cam shows the pass to Antoine as he screens and just slides away and rides it up. Only Antoine makes as many shots that you think you've contested. Surprisingly, good pop off the floor. 2:09 to play. Jamison has the Lakers up by 5.
And Thomas are 20 for 30 from the floor. All other Kings are 11 for 37. So their big three are getting it done. Jamison, nothing but net from three. And the former Terrapin of Maryland has it right now. 6 on the clock. He's eyeing it. He's going to rise and shoot a three. He's got it. As on cue, Mike Trudell.
Got to keep playing. They're not going to give up. The Lakers lead it 86-76. Something, when he does something, the clock runs out.
It's amazing, though, the Kings not giving the Lakers anything easily. Blake, well, I'll tell you what.
Come back and go up by a couple.
If they win, just a half game out of 7th, Tyreke Evans gets behind the defense, but coming over was Antoine Jamison.
About 7 feet, it's tough, long distance to go down and try to pick something up off the floor, but talked about defense, could have been, should have been goaltending.
Yeah.
Not allowed to touch the, hit the net. They've let a 12-point lead just about evaporate here.
It's only a 4-point lead. Again, Evans, and that time Dwight smothered it. Steve Blake, wraparound pass, bad decision. It's a 4-on-1. And they botch it up. What a break for the Lakers and a play by Blake. Blake is smiling ear to ear.
Just don't want to give the ball to a big in the middle of the floor where he has to make decisions or change directions. Loses control of it, does Thompson, then runs right over Steve Blake. So after turning it over himself, Steve Blake hustles back and kind of redeems himself. 20 points for Patterson coming back.
Nash going back to Phoenix. Tomorrow night, he hits the outside jump shot.
Took the contact and didn't move.
Nash, who averages about 12 and a half points a game, has 14 tonight. Blocked by Dwight. That time he kept it in play. He's running the floor now. Let's see if he can get rewarded at the other end. Instead, it's Blake hitting the three. Steve Blake does it again.
Firepower guy. Dwight Howard starts it all. Rejecting the shot by Thornton. Blake ends it with the triple. And that will be a dogfight.
Nash, three, in and out, back in again. Isolation down on the low block, kicks it back, good ball movement. Now Mehta's gonna try to attack, cut it back out to Jamison. He's allowed, he hits it.
Lane to Antoine Jamison. Our Carl's cam shows how Steve Nash takes the pass from Dwight. In, out, back in again for the triple. And as you mentioned, Nash now 1 out of 2 from that position. Tyreke took the shot that was well off the mark.
Remember when this game kind of took a turn when it was that 4-on-1 break and they didn't convert? Ever since then, it's been all Lakers, including that shot by Mehta, world peace. And 7 Lakers have played. 6 of them are in double figures. Think about that. 7 have played, 6 in double figures. That's balance.
Dwight Howard! Volleyball spiked it down.
See, that's another one of those. It looks great. Just grabbed that P. 5 seconds to be exact. And the Lakers, with Dwight saying, Isaiah, you just gotta elevate a little higher than that. Swats it out of bounds, but the Kings get it back and make a hoop. Subs of the game, and there has to be two for the Lakers. Of course, Steve Blake, 8 assists, 5 rebounds, and 16 points. And then the other sub, of course, the only other guy off the bench, Antoine Jameson. Game high, 26 points, 8 rebounds. And one of the things I like about both of them, especially Jameson.
The game changer on Time Warner Cable Sports Net. Isaiah Thomas all the way. Another block by Dwight. Five blocks for Dwight Howard. D12. D12 with another block. Steve Nash. Pull up. Yes, sir!
That's something that they'll probably talk about as a staff.
World Peace trying to back in. His fallaway jumper. That's in. Count it!
Because we've been talking about so many other people, as Meta World Peace working over Tyreek Evans, gets him into the paint and then just steps back and throws it up, gets the whistle. Three-point opportunity. Jody Meeks comes in, replaced Posier, went on for the win. And our Jeep star performer of the game, Antoine Jameson. Off the bench, 27 points, 5 out of 8 from three-point land. He had 9 rebounds, and he is just playing offensively in a zone. And because of that, he is our star performer. He summed it up in his post-game interview, talking about the sense of urgency. Every single game, every single minute, you got to play with that urgency.
All right, for Stu and Mike, I'm Bill McDonald saying so long from Staples Center. Final 113-102. Make sure to catch the Lakers and the Suns tomorrow at 7 o'clock. Time to check in with the studio for Access Sportsnet Lakers, presented by your Southern California Hyundai dealers.